Hi, this is Alex, and in today's Lightroom video, I'm going to show two techniques that can help with forest photos like these. The first one is simulating the effect of a polarizing filter on foliage to reduce glare and increase the green saturation so that this whole stuff is not as busy. And the second technique, where the first one fails, is to salvage these completely blown out areas that are beyond recovery here. You can see if I reduce my exposure to like -3 here, there's nothing happening here. No color comes back in these places. It's just a gray now instead of a white. So that means the information in here is 100% lost to overexposure. You can see that I already made some adjustments to the photo here. What sticks out are the shadows and blacks, both at plus 100. This is something that I do when I have a scene like this where I already have a problem with overexposed areas. So to make it lighter, I do not want to increase exposure because that affects all the tones equally. And because shadows doesn't have the effect that I seek alone, blacks helps to make that whole image a lot lighter and reduce the overall contrast without touching the exposure slider here, which would only lead to further overexposure. So before any global adjustments and after, this is what it looks like. Now the first technique is to simulate a polarizing filter. And as you may have guessed, I do that with a mask. And for this particular usage, I use a color range mask. And I will sample from these tiny little leaves here that show pretty much the most glare. I zoom in. When the tool is already active, I can do that by pressing and holding the space bar. And then I can use the magnifier. Now I sample the color here, and that nicely selects these more light green tones. But we can see that by default, the range also includes areas that do not necessarily need so much fixing. So with my overlay activated here, I might use the refine slider and reduce the range here to only affect the lighter parts of the greens. And now zoomed out, again, I press and hold my spacebar and I simply click while the tool is still active. I can make adjustments to mimic the look of a polarizer. The first thing that I want to do here is reduce the overall clarity. Clarity is micro contrast, local contrast. So reducing that makes bright parts flatter. And this makes the whole glare softer already, as you can see. I don't want to drag this down to minus 100 because then it looks too flat and we're losing some contrast and detail that's useful for us. So a range between 50 and 60 is good. And the second adjustment that I want to make is to shift all this more into the green. You see my color sample here is kind of a gray-green. So I push the green tint from the white balance adjustments all the way to minus 100, pure green. And that reduces this grayish color on the green. And I have a much more vibrant green already, which is exactly what the polarizer does. Maybe on top of that, I want to increase the saturation here a little bit too, to really get close to what a polarizer would do if I had a lush green forest scene in front of me. Very, very rich green colors, right? And this is our polarizer emulation. I can do a quick before and after. I click and hold the eye symbol here, and you can see how all this glare is reduced and turned into a very nice, intensive, richly saturated green now. If I wanted to reduce the effect and apply it only to certain areas, I could do that now with the intersect tool. But I think overall, even though the reach of the tool is fairly bright here, if we see all the areas that are affected by it, it actually has a really good effect. So I do not really need to reduce that here. And I can proceed to my second fix, and that's salvaging these super bright areas here. For that, I create a new mask and this time I choose to sample a luminance range because I want to primarily affect the brightest highlights here. Again, zoomed in, I sample the bright highlights, and that luminance range here in the overlay, easily visible, includes way too much, and we're going to reduce that right now here to a very, very small range, maybe like so. We want a little bit of a transition area, so we're not pushing it all the way to 100, and you'll see why in a later step. And this is our starting point, and now we want to play around and see how we can reduce most effectively what's blown out here. And the first step would, of course, be, again, just like I previously did, the negative clarity. And this time I set this to minus 100 all the way down because that pushes those whites a little bit away. And you see it has too much of a reach already, so I don't want to do that. But for now, I'm playing and just want to see what has the best effect on the white highlights. And the second step would be to reduce my highlights. And now I can get this into a gray range, which is very helpful because I have those brightest spots reduced to a more controllable range, but they're lacking color now. So as a third ingredient, I'm using a color overlay, and I use this yellow green, and I put that over this here and set the coloration to a maximum, the saturation here. And now I have, instead of gray highlights, yellow green highlights, so that's good. Maybe I also add negative texture to this, makes it all softer. And I think, just by comparing my luminance range adjustment before and after, I can already see that I have reduced these highlights a great bit. But the reach is way too much, of course. So the first thing I want to do is I want to subtract actual greens from this so that they're not affected by it. I simply click here. That makes it better. But still have some areas here that look really, really crappy now. So I want to further reduce that and really only use it as a cosmetic adjustment in the finest areas. And I intersect that now with a brush. And my brush set to a flow of 80, a pretty good starting point. What's a little bit confusing is perhaps before I place the first brush stroke, the mask still affects the entire image. As soon as I place the first brush stroke, it will only affect the area where I'm actually brushing. So, and I know that this here is one of my brightest spots, so I begin on this and I simply brush over that here. And maybe for these very, very bright areas, I can even set my flow to 100 so I get the maximum effect with a single brush stroke. And as you can see, now simply painting with my brush over these bright highlighted areas brings them down so much that they don't stick out that much. They're not an eyesore anymore. And with my green color overlay, I camouflage that this is actually blown out whites here. I think those are the worst offenders. Now I want to reduce the flow of my brush to perhaps 70 or 80 so I can brush over the rest of the image multiple times before the effect fully builds up. I can actually zoom out for this and identify a couple of the worst areas here that need a brush stroke or two with my salvage brush here. These ferns here for sure. I guess those two. This area here. There's some very bright leaf here. We can brush over those as well. And you get the idea here. I need to spend some time on all these small highlight areas and simply brush over them to reduce their intensity and apply that green color overlay. Oh, here's a nice one. Look at that in that tree. And you see it still leaves some very tiny jagged lines here, transition areas. But I am zoomed in to a 200% magnification here so that we can clearly see what's happening. In a real world scenario, I don't think this is going to be an issue. And the improvement that I have from this technique far outweighs these tiny, tiny little artifacts that I'm introducing with my brush here. Zoom that. It all might look a little bit flat now that I've combined these two masks before and after. So I can perhaps bring back a little bit clarity to that overall scene, maybe reduce my texture to compensate for this. Oh, I notified another nasty little highlight here. So I can go back to my mask, activate the brush, and just make a little click here and reduce that. If I find anything else, just by visual inspection of the whole frame, I could reduce those little highlights here with that same brush. Just going over the entire image and only fixing what needs fixing with the brush. And that's it for this video. I think the improvement is quite nice. Again, I disable my masks. I have blown out areas and I have a very busy foreground. And afterwards, with my masks, everything is much more homogeneous. The greens are richer and these blown out highlights here are eliminated as well with my second mask, which I can turn off and on separately. And I think that reduces a huge distraction here in the frame. As usual, I hope you liked this video. That's it from me this time. See you soon. Bye.